Unlike the USA and most of Europe seeking to turn back the tide of immigration, there is today one country actively seeking colonists. That is the newly formed nation of Asgardia, the largest ever space platform designed for insertion into Earth's orbit. The founding father of Asgardia is Dr. Igor Ashurbeyli, a descendant of the nobility of Azerbaijan, scientist and businessman, and chairman of UNESCO's Science and Space Committee. In a press conference held in Paris on October 12, 2016, as part of the manifest destiny of all mankind to leave our home planet and colonize the stars, he announced the formation of Asgardia, a micronation to which 500,000 people worldwide have already applied for citizenship. The breakaway nation takes its name from Asgard, one of the nine realms of the Norse gods, which is connected to Earth by Bifrost, the Rainbow Bridge. Asgard is the most fertile land of Norse legend, wealthy with jewels and gold, whose residents excel in knowledge and talent. The new country aspires one day to be recognized by the United Nations. The UN Space Treaty currently prohibits any claim of national sovereignty in outer space. However, Asgardia would not seem to be bound by this treaty because it is not yet a United Nations member. The first piece of the platform is scheduled to be launched into low Earth orbit before the end of 2017. According to Ashurbeyli, the space nation's purpose will be to protect the Earth. Asgardia will track and remove space junk, the orbital debris threatening to choke the traffic in our space lanes. Derelict satellites will be targeted by projectiles, which will attach themselves to debris and then open up into a solar sail, using the sun's energy to drag the dead hunk of metal into a lower orbit, where it will burn up completely upon re-entry into the atmosphere. We must protect the planet from an inevitable coronal mass ejection, a kind of solar flare on steroids, which could fry half of our working communications satellites, eradicating GPS tracking, cell phone networks, and the internet, as well as the very power grid itself. Asgardia would establish an outpost at that so-called parking place in space, the orbital Lagrange point, L1, where it could generate a protective magnetic force field strong enough to deflect harmful particles from the sun. The Earth must also be protected from asteroid impact. The most effective and cheapest way to do this is with a nuclear warhead, detonated near the path of the hurtling celestial body, altering its course. This would make Asgardia the 10th nation to possess nuclear weapons, after North Korea. The mining of asteroids in stable orbit will be Asgardia's main source of income. Her easy access to the tremendous surplus of our solar system's raw materials will make Asgardia the richest country in the world. And at this time, Asgardian citizenship is open to any man or woman on our planet. Visit the new website, asgardia.space, to apply for citizenship. Any human being over the age of 18 may submit an application by answering only 4 questions. First name, last name, email, and country of origin. But prospective colonists should do this right away. Initial enrollment is currently capped at 1 million applicants. 500,000 have already applied in less than 2 weeks' time. A mere 10% of these candidates, or 100,000 people, are to be granted citizenship, which comes with a passport.
Central Earth Zone, Commander Campbell. Yes, thank you. Good Earth Day. That was Supervisor McDonald. The Exeter just landed with 50 customers. I knew that cell would bring them in. Well, it's not often we get customers from the Martian colony.
I think I'll move to Mars. I'm freezing my diodes off.